for a breath of good sea air, the entrance fee onto the pier is 2.5 pence. And that's fine for hardier types who enjoy a spot of fishing, or take a boat to Swanage, or even take a trip around the bay. Alas, no longer in the saucy Sal, but in a hovercraft priced at 60 pence. But in spite of claims by the corporation that the air is free of pollution, and an earlier claim by a few doctors that the place was positively therapeutic, the main attraction still remains the narrow strip of sand between the town and the sea, the beach. The beach is narrow, and it does get crowded, but it's sandy, the right golden colour, and commendably clean, despite the daily avalanche of wrappers, paper bags, old newspapers and bottles, that the British holidaymaker seems to feel is his right to leave behind. Well, that was something we noticed in the very pretty gardens and parks in Bournemouth, often an elegant lawn peppered with waste paper from a few thoughtless tourists. And with a million of those each year, that does add up to a sizeable pile of rubbish. But the beach is fairly uncluttered. There are no sunshades for hire, not many boats, and no cafes on the beach. The deck chairs cost sixpence per session. But what is it that brings the crowds to Bournemouth?
Well, for me, there's a certain amount of nostalgia about Bournemouth. It takes you back to the Bucket and Spade days. But apart from that, I think I've travelled to almost every country in the world, and I do say this outside of the present case, that Bournemouth is the place for me. It's got a very relaxing air with it, and it's a town where old and young seem to mix very amicably.
We have a happy hotel atmosphere and the homely people. That really is why we come, the homeliness of it.
Well, you seem to get plenty of sunshine here. It may start cloudy in the morning, but it brightens up by midday.
Well, I've been before when I was younger. It's a bit better than Weston, Weymouth, places around there. A lot of people seem to come here, so we've decided to, you know, there's a lot of little places you can go as well, you see.
Why do you choose Bournemouth?
Well, I come with him.
The British holidaymaker is, almost by tradition, a sort of hardy perennial. It has to be jolly chilly or indeed raining for the beach to be abandoned. But if that happens in the morning when the theatres and the cinemas are closed, what does one do? Well, from my point of view, it's no problem at all. Shopping. Either window shopping or spending shopping. Because Bournemouth does boast an excellent selection of shops, many of them not normally found outside the lush confines of London's West End. And as well as shops, there's a zoo over in Poole, an ice rink here in the centre of town, as well as in Southbourne, an exhibition of over 1 million seashells. There are some excellent golf courses and tennis courts. And if the children are bored, what about a ride on an open-top double-decker bus? This is the last remaining original Bournemouth bath chair. This one was in use from 1920 to 1950, and the fare was 1 and 6 pence an hour. Can you imagine trying to get a taxi today for 7.5 pence an hour? And there's a sort of marvellous seclusion about sitting in one, but I must say, I can't help feeling sorry for the poor men behind who did all the pushing. It's rather like a giant pram, but at least the passengers had to do the steering themselves. To the pavilion, James!